Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install CodeBlocks. So if you like this video, then please give it a like and also please do share it with your friends. And also don't forget to subscribe our channel. That will really help me to motivate to make more such videos. So let's see how to install CodeBlocks. So for that, first you need to go to your favorite browser, and in that this bar you need to just simply search with CodeBlocks download and hit enter. And you will get codeblocks.org as our first result. So download CodeBlocks, click on that, and it will going to redirect you to the official site of CodeBlocks. So here you need to click on download the binary release, and it will going to redirect to the official site. So this site is currently having some issue, but no problem. You need to just simply scroll down, and here you can see that we have binary releases, and here we have, you know, the exe for Windows, Linux and macOS. So depending upon what operating system you are using, you need to select that. If you are using Mac, then you need to select this. If you are using Linux, then you need to select this, and for Windows this one. Okay, for Windows you need to click on this link, and it will going to show you this, you know, Microsoft Windows all in type of installer. Now here is the most important part. Do remember to download this CodeBlocks 20.03 MinGW setup.exe. This MinGW setup is the one that you need to download. Okay, you are not supposed to download any other version, because you'll need a compiler. That's the most important part. Why you are downloading this? Because here you have this MinGW compiler. Okay, CodeBlocks is the IDE where you can do the C and C++ programming, but the MinGW is the compiler. Okay, so I'll recommend you to download this one. So here you can click any of these two, FossHub or sourceforge.net. I'm going to click this sourceforge.net, and it will going to redirect to this SourceForge official site. And here you can see after 5 seconds it will going to start automatically downloading our CodeBlocks. So you can see our CodeBlock is rightly started downloading. So let's wait for some time to finish, you know, downloading our CodeBlocks. So as you can see, our CodeBlocks is rightly installed. So just simply click on this, you know, installer to install our CodeBlocks. And also I'll minimize my browser. So it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and you can see our CodeBlocks installation wizard is rightly open. Okay, so here you need to just simply click on next, and this is our license agreement. You can always read this license agreement, and then you can click on I agree. And see, it going to install, you know, our default install, so which will contain this contribution plugin, then various other things like launcher, then the main important thing is this MinGW compiler shoot. Okay, so it also going to install this MinGW compiler along with our IDE. And here you can see that it required 531.5 MB of free space, so that's the important thing. Okay, you can keep all other things as default. Click on next. And here it going to be installed, which is totally fine. Just simply click on install, and there you go, our installation has rightly begun. So let's wait for a couple of minutes to, you know, complete this installation, and then I'll again come back. Yep, so we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our CodeBlock, it almost installed, and it is asking whether do you like to, you know, run your CodeBlocks now. So you can just simply click on yes, and it will going to, you know, complete our, you know, CodeBlock installation, and then it's going to launch our CodeBlock. So you can see that our CodeBlock is rightly launched, and this is basically the interface of our CodeBlock. So you can create a new project, or you can open an existing project, or if you want to see how to use CodeBlock, then you can just simply use this tip of the day, and you can, you know, learn how to use CodeBlock. But don't worry, in this video I'm going to show you, you know, how we can easily use CodeBlock. So you don't need to do anything. What you can do is you need to just simply go to file, and then hover over new, and here you need to click on the file. So what it will do, you it will going to ask you like what type of file you would like to open. So I'm going to, you know, click on the C and C++ source file. So just simply double click on that, and here you can just simply click on next, and you can choose what language you'd like to work on, whether it is a C language or C++. Depending upon that, you can, you know, write your program. So if you want to go with C, just simply choose C, click on next, and you need to give the file name with full path over here. So you need to click on this triple dot, and in our document directory, let's, you know, give the file name as hello world and dot C, and just, you know, going to save this file, and there you go. Just simply click on finish, and it will going to create the file over here. See, hello world. Okay, so here you can write the simple hello world program. So hash include stdio.h, okay, then int main, give, you know, a parenthesis and write printf hello world. Okay, just end with semicolon and a return 0. Okay, so we are, you know, declared our main method as int main, so we need to return something. So write this much and click on this run button, and it is asking whether you like to build it now. So yes. So after, you know, successfully build, so it is throwing some error that because our, you know, include spelling is wrong. So let's correct it. Hash include, you know, now just simply run it, build, yes, and there you go, the output hello world is rightly shown. Okay, so in this way you can easily, you know, install code blocks. I have also shown you, if you want to, you know, code in C++, that also you can do. Just you need to click on, you know, here C++, and then you need to click on next, and here if you choose C++, then it will, you know, automatically going to ask you to give the file extension .cpp. For C++ it is .cpp, for C it is just .c. okay, that's all. Then next steps are pretty much same. Okay, so that's all for this video. If you face any more difficulty, please do comment in our comment sections. I am always there to help you. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also please do subscribe our channel. It will really help me to make more such videos. And also don't forget to share with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.